Cornell Cooperative Extension of Orange County presents. Welcome to Cat Science, hosted by Orange County, New York 4-H. Today is our second lesson, treating Giardia and roundworms and the daily care to recovery. So first, when we brought Pollo home, we noticed some signs. The signs that we noticed were that he had foul-smelling diarrhea, watery stool, he did vomit once, his stool kind of looked a little mucousy, he was skinny, he did have a large stomach or pot belly, he seemed to be having poor growth based upon his estimated age, and he did have worms in his stool. So when we brought him home, we made our appointment anyway for the following week. But we called our vet right back, and they were able to get us in the following day to get our little Pollo checked out. Pollo wound up being diagnosed with Giardia and roundworms, and that's why we're learning about them today. So what is Giardia? Giardia is an intestinal infection that humans and animals can contract. That's known as zoonotic. Giardia is a protozoal parasite. Giardia comes in two forms, hardy, which is a cystic form that is shed in feces and can last in the environment for several months, and a fragile form that lives in the gut of an infected animal. So what is a roundworm? Roundworms are the most common intestinal parasite of a cat. These are large-bodied worms. The average size is 3 to 6 inches long, and they swim freely within the intestines because they do not attach to the wall. So how did Pollo get Giardia and roundworms? So roundworms are transmammary or milk-borne infection is a major route for kittens to receive the transmission of this. So that means that Pollo's mom could have had roundworms and they could have passed through her milk when she fed him, or he could have been eating something off the ground and picked them up himself. So what about Giardia? Giardia is ingested at the cystic stage of the parasite. So this happens when it's passing along to other animals through the feces in the environment. Pollo could have picked this up from drinking in a puddle or eating something also on the ground. So what does that mean? Giardia is not so common in kittens, but roundworms are. Giardia is found in normally colonies of cats who live outside or a pet store, things like that, as well as they contract roundworms too. So we know that we adopted Pollo from a barn, so he was living in a colony of cats that is outside, even though they're very well taken care of by the farmer. He did wind up contracting these things, and it's very much so treatable. So let's get into treatment. Treatment. Go to your vet. As you can see, our cute little Pollo is at his first vet visit there. He's on the table and looking around. So what's going to happen at the vet is that they are going to run a stool sample, and they're going to provide you with proper medication. So Pollo first went in on 6/12/20, and he was taking 1/4 of a tablet of his medication every 12 hours. Now this has to do with based on his age and his weight, but mostly his weight. He did also have to do one dose based on his weight again, and that was 0.4 pounds of a dose of panic cure. So then in 10 days later, we rechecked his stool. And then after that, in 3 weeks, we redid the meds. So on 7/6/20, we increased to a half a pill and also a larger dose of the panic cure because his weight increased, and we're very happy about that. After that, Pollo received a clean bill of health, and he was Giardia and roundworm free. So what else do we do? We take them to the vet. We keep everything very clean. It's important that you're keeping not only your animal clean, but their environment clean where they are staying. Giardia can be passed through the feces, so we know in potty training that can be embedded into their nails, into their feet, under their tail, okay? And they can spread that. It's not so common that they do spread that to humans, but it's always important that we are always washing our hands and, again, keeping a clean environment. That means cleaning Pollo on a regular basis, as well as cleaning his environment on a regular basis.
All right, guys, so what are you working on this morning?
Cat chores.
Cat chores. So we are working on cat chores. For the cat's kennel, because he's still so little, he sleeps in here at night. So
he's right here.
He's right there. So every morning we clean out his kennel and wash his bedding because he just finished his round of treatment for Giardia. And later on, we are going to give Pollo a bath. So Frankly and Riley are sweeping out, and then we'll start mopping.
And also, look how big he got.
He did get big. And then I'm going to go in the kitchen, and I'm going to wash out the litter pan and his food dish, okay? So I'll see you guys in a few minutes. Yep.
After we sweep, we mop.
All right, keep going. After we mop, we're going to use a sanitizing solution on the tray bottom as well.
What's a sanitizing?
Sanitizing solution. So we're going to make sure all the germs are off. And it's nice and clean for Pollo, who is very appreciative that his kennel's being clean. All right.
And he's also a good boy and also a bad boy. He always bites me.
Yes. All right, so let's get mopping. So their next chore is that they're going to put clean litter in the cat box. So go ahead, Frankie.
I want to do it.
Perfect. So Riley is going to take the litter box and she's going to put it where it goes. So Riley, do you want to slide that in?
Yeah.
Move little Pollo out of the way. So nice and straight.
Just make him walk away.
It's okay, just pick him up.
I got
perfect.
Got it.
Awesome.
I think he needs
to. So turn it the other way, sweets. Turn it the other way. So it's, it goes this way, flat this way. Perfect.
Perfect like that.
All right.
Now.
Just a little cat toy. And now we are going to get his food ready. And again, we'll show you that. All right, so the kids are now getting Pollo's breakfast ready. So
yeah, because he haven't ate breakfast in a long time. Because I just got here first.
Mm-hmm. So the first thing that they're going to do is Frank is going to scoop in half a can of the wet food. And then Riley is going to do a handful of the dry food.
Do we have to, do this?
There you go. Great job, Frank. Okay, and Riley, go ahead, put some dry food in there. I'll move it right out of your way. There you go, sweetheart. Just hold on to it. Yep, go ahead, just put it right on top of the wet food. Wet food, there we go. So grab the dry food out of there so we can put water in there. Perfect.
I saw the
I know, he's excited. He's hungry.
I didn't know that.
So as you can see, Pollo's very hungry. So Frank is going to put his food right in on his mat. Okay, and we will show you what the rest of his cat palace looks like after he's done munching.
Look how cute he is.
He is. All right, guys, so what's the most important part after cat chores?
Washing your hands.
All right, so wash your hands up. And then we'll get ready for the rest of our chores for the day.
Yeah, this is the last chore.
So all of Pollo's bedding is washed, his cage is clean, and he's all ready for his nighttime slumber when he decides. It's so important that we make sure that their areas are always nice and clean. So what else do we do? Our job is to make sure that we're giving the medication properly, whether it be a pill being put in his food, or it be, you can see on the side where he's receiving a dose of his Panicure, okay? And it is a little tricky to give your cats some medication, so if you are not experienced, please let your vet know that, and they're gonna show you how to do that. In our videos later on, you're gonna see, and I'll explain how to properly give a syringe medication orally to your kitten.
Hi guys, so I just wanted to tune back in with you and let you know that Pollo is receiving his final dose of Panacure, which is his medicine for his Giardia. So I'm going to teach you guys how to do that with my trusty camera person. So bear with us. So what we're going to first do is we're going to make sure we're going to get him where he's nice and calm. And we're going to flip him over. And we have to try to restrain them so they don't hurt themselves when he needs to have medication. So it comes in a handy dandy syringe right from our vet. And as you can see, his dose for his second dosage that he was on, because he had to be on this twice, is a lot larger because he gained some weight. So we're really excited about that. So the first thing that we're gonna do is that we're going to take our syringe, we're gonna insert it in his mouth and do a little bit at a time. And then we'll do the final dose. And he's all set. So he is all free and clear. We go back to the vet for some more shots in another week or so. Thanks for tuning in.
And as always, after the clean bill of health, the most important thing is lots of snuggles. Thanks for joining us, and we'll catch you on our next episode.